TFNN.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks, and a great weekend. You have the power to create. Your power is so strong that whatever you believe comes true. You are that way because that is what you believe about yourself, your whole reality. Everything you believe is your creation. It's a beautiful thing, folks. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials close up 10, NASDAQ down 39, S&P's down 8. Bottom line, folks, you get a sideways market out here. You had light volume. We had wide price spread out here yesterday. You didn't have the volume yesterday. We didn't have the volume today. But guess what? When you go higher with the wide price spread that we had, bottom line, I expect we're going to get to a slightly higher high. Today, having a sideways market, pulling back slightly with light volume, that's telling me tomorrow morning, PPI, whatever is in it, bottom line, looks like it wants to go a little bit higher. Gold contract down $4.60 trading at $12.24 an ounce. We have silver down 15 cents, $14.41 an ounce. Let's go over and take a look at the silver market first. Gold absolutely pulled back, dramatically lighter volume. Bottom line is that still wants higher price. We go take a look at silver. Silver's down 1%. Traded to $14.33. Had 87,000 contracts. And that is coming into, okay, this is going to be cool too, because that's coming into 122,000. Okay, that's still a setup that it does want higher price. The energy market, folks, it's a beautiful thing. If you're in the Midwest, if you're in the Northeast, your price of oil is going down dramatically. In fact, I'll go over to heating oil first. Heating oil was down 6.5 pennies out here today. You're at $2.17 per gallon for heating oil. Now, that is down from a high that was generated out here on October 2nd of 245. That, you know, bottom line, that's a good number. It certainly isn't the number that we have in the gasoline market. Gasoline, folks, trading at a price point wholesale of $1.64. We are down from $2.14 at $1.64. And the way that the gasoline market is set up, it looks to me that we are going to be getting some really sweet prices in gasoline, because when we take a look at this, what you're going to see, actually, we're down from 214, but the 214 is from just this October 15th. We're actually down from 228. Now, if we take a look at the gasoline market, what you're going to see is that, next stop is about 140. That's where we're kind of standing. You have the support comes in like at about $1.70. Well, we're barreled into this $1.70. So now it's game down there to about $1.40, which is really cool in the aspect of the amount of money that we can save filling our tanks up each and every week. And there is a cumulative effect on that, folks, because what does happen is that, we all use gas. That's the bottom line. Notes and bonds, this is going to be a big toss-up out here. Once again, we had the Federal Reserve turn around and say, hey, listen, carte blanche is out here. We do expect that we're still going to go up on short-term rates. Now, the 10-year note went down 8 ticks. Nothing big there. The volume isn't big, but this is what you do have. You're not holding price. Now the volume was anemic compared to, yesterday you were pushing higher with 2.3 million contracts. You came lower today with 1.2. That being said, we're getting close to the cliff. Where the cliff is laid out inside the 10-year, folks, is 117.13. That's our last low. If we hang around here too much longer, then the bottom line is that, we can basically jump over that cliff. If we look at the 30-year, let's go U.S. 30-year out here. Come on. Oh, yeah. The 30 is dangerous. 30-year is right at it. So the 30-year, we right now at 137, and 136.16 is the number. So we'll see where this shakes out tomorrow morning, because This is dangerous where we're at inside that 30-year. If we take a look at the yield structure in the 10-year right now, we're at 3.241. And in fact, on the 10-year, this is hit a high. It's hit a high, I believe, only for the 3 months. One second, let me see for the year. Yeah, that's the high for the year also. Right now, so for the past 12 months, the low of the 10-year yield is 2.319. The high, 3.241, we're at it. That's on your 10-year. If we go back, I want to see this 30-year where the 30-year is shaking out. So the 30-year right now also, so what you'll hear this tonight, the bottom line is that the notes and bonds, they are at highs for the year. The 30-year trading 3.435. Big number. Some of the higher volume equities in this market out here today. Oh, King Dollar. Let's go to King Dollar first. So, King Dollar, folks, got over its August 15th high once again. Now, King Dollar had wide price spread. Didn't have the volume, but guess what? You had the price spread. We went up almost 700 ticks. We're up 688 ticks. You did 17,800 contracts. That's light contract volume. The last time that we were up here, the first time that it took it out, we took it out with 16,400. It got up to a high with 22,000 and then bang, got out of that high, came barreling down first with 29,000 contracts, then with 31,000 contracts, and yesterday with 34,000. So this is going to be a major test once again. It's testing once again, and we'll figure out how, well, we'll know tomorrow how this shakes out. When you do go to higher highs and you have lighter volume like this and we came off them, the probability is that we won't be up there too much longer. But what I do expect you're going to see is that that PPI number in the morning will give us a clue. Well, it'll move the dollar. That's the bottom line. We're going to take a look at the gold contract. Gold contract out here pulled back, dramatically lighter volume. We pulled back, and that didn't get the price going either. We pulled back $4.40, 220,000 contracts. Well, that's going into 313 as well as 532,000 contracts. So the way that the metals market is still set up, it still wants higher price. Stay right there, folks. Lots of numbers coming out after this close. Right now, Dow Industrials. In fact, Disney. Disney just came out with numbers. If we look at Disney, Disney closed at 116. That's trading 117.93. And as soon as we come back, we'll have those numbers for you.